COVID cases are continuing to surge in Queensland and hospital rates are on the rise, but the government isn't panicking yet. The Chief Health Officer, though, has released a statistic that should have all unvaccinated Queenslanders rushing to get the jab.
Few will dispute Queensland's COVID journey has been a long and blurry one, but the state's Chief Health Officer is confident, thanks to the vaccine, things are becoming clearer.
If we didn't have a vaccination program as we've had in the last 12 months here in Queensland, the health system would clearly be overwhelmed.
For a second day running, Queensland has surpassed 20,000 daily cases. The new count, 22,069, up from 20,466 infections yesterday.
3,985 of those are people who have registered a positive rapid antigen test, so thank you.
The hospital rate is again steady, a slight rise overnight from 502 patients yesterday to 525 today. There's now 30 patients in ICU, 8 of whom are on ventilators.
We've had well over 100,000 documented cases, and it's likely to be large, much larger number of true cases of COVID-19 in the community. And yet, we're still seeing these small numbers of patients in our intensive care unit.
But the state's top doc is under no illusions. The number will grow as the Omicron wave worsens. He admits if we continue to vaccinate in Queensland, we will defeat the virus and our hospitals will cope.
If you are unvaccinated, you are 9 times more likely to end up in a Queensland hospital than if you are triple vaxxed.
Queensland's current vaccine rate, single dose, is 91.23%, while the double dose rate sits at 88%. And to date, over 745,000 boosters have been administered.
And I remind all Queenslanders that it has been 4 months since your second dose, then you can get your booster shot now.
Just last night, Nine News revealed this email sent from the Paramedics Association calling for their Commissioner Craig Emery to return from his annual leave and show face. Well, today, the Health Minister, Yvette Darth, hosed down any suggestions that her commissioner has gone missing during the pandemic.
Craig, although he's officially on leave, has been involved in every briefing. He has been involved in meetings and conversations with stakeholders on a daily basis and has been involved in the decision making.
When the government changed its policy on PCR tests last week, we did see a reduction in the lineups across the southeast. However, the government admits there is still a massive issue when it comes to testing across the state. We did hear last week that the Premier, Anastasia Palaszczuk, secured 18 million rapid antigen tests. But the big problem is still supply. We are expecting at least a million rapid antigen tests to arrive courtesy of the federal government this week. However, over half of them are those care at home tests, which will still then soak up a significant amount of Queensland health resources. The Health Minister, Yvette Darth, though, said she will continue to source as many tests as she can, especially as this Omicron wave continues to spread.
Let's hope they keep flowing in, Peter. Thank you for that. As students around the state come to terms with a delayed start to term one, a number of private schools have opted for a different approach. They're moving to bring back online learning, giving their pupils a head start.
After years of disrupted learning, Year 12 students like Abigail Bold had been looking forward to 2022 being a bit more business as usual.
I'm just really keen to get into it.
Until the state government announced a delay to the school year.
In this current environment, I don't think there's a clear or perfect solution to anything.
But now some private schools like St Paul's are making a different call, instead bringing back remote learning for those first 2 weeks.
I think it's a good opportunity to get back into the routine of things. It's a little scary going into grade 12.
The school's principal making the call to provide meaningful opportunities for children of essential workers, while also ensuring those at home aren't unfairly disadvantaged, saying we are required to be open from this date, so it makes sense to ensure that learning can begin from this time. Brisbane Girls Grammar School students today informed online learning will return from January 31, while others are still weighing up their options, hoping to avoid too much COVID disruption.
And as cases in the state continue to skyrocket, along with the number of close contacts, there are concerns about the impact it could have on public transport. Reduced timetables are now being considered for buses, ferries and trains.
I know Transport and Main Roads are talking with the stakeholders around these plans.
Nothing set in stone yet. Contingency plans still being worked through.
As the number of cases escalate and as staff end up needing to go offline because they are positive or they are close contacts.
Meg Sides, Nine News.
The workforce shortages crippling many crucial industries will be front and centre when National Cabinet meets tomorrow. The leaders will consider ditching close contact isolation rules for more workers, while the federal government says it may also call on older or unemployed Australians for help.
They're classrooms for our littlest learners. But COVID rules have spelled trouble for childcare centres around the country.
We currently have 11 staff out at the moment and trying to pull together just to try and make ends meet has been really, really difficult.
It's been really difficult for many other industries too. Today, Scott Morrison met with his ministers after a series of crisis talks with sectors crippled by workplace shortages.
The challenge of COVID with escalating cases is keeping things moving.
Moving ahead with a plan to ditch isolation rules for more workers. Tomorrow, National Cabinet will consider expanding the list of close contacts who can return to work immediately after a negative test, with those in transport and logistics front of the queue.
We need to see people that are asymptomatic being allowed to return to work across the country.
And Nine News understands the federal government has agreed to
increasing the number of hours that international students can work.
And may also turn to older Australians.
We certainly want to encourage those older Australians, particularly those who've got skills in some of the critical industries, to consider maybe going back and doing a few hours' work.
And the unemployed.
We're very keen to be talking to them about what assistance they might need to get them to move into some of these critical jobs.
We would absolutely take anybody ready and willing to work.
Workers in the food supply chain have already been told they can skip isolation if they're close contacts with no symptoms. But supermarkets are struggling to catch up.
With supermarkets running low on stock due to workforce issues, Coles has placed new national purchase limits on toilet paper and painkillers. And in all states except WA, there are also restrictions on some meat.
It's hoped these sites will soon be rare, with supplies expected to increase in coming days. Fiona Willen, Nine News.